Apple's Touch Bar on the MacBook Pro can be extremely annoying, so I'm going to show you how to set it up, customize it, and make it easier to use. Ever since the new virtual Touch Bar came out on the MacBook Pro, I've wasted approximately 1,221,457 seconds of my life reaching out to wake up the Touch Bar so I can turn up the volume or turn down the brightness. It is a problem. Don't you just miss those old school keys that you could just reach out and press to make changes on your MacBook Pro? I know I do. One of the first settings you can change is to turn your Touch Bar back into the more traditional buttons found on the older MacBook Pros. Go to System Preferences, select Keyboard. Under the Touch Bar shows a drop-down menu, select Expanded Control Strip. This will make your Touch Bar look more like the old school MacBook Pro buttons at the top of the keyboard. From left to right, you have your brightness settings, mission control, launchpad, keyboard brightness controls, the player controls, volume controls, and last but not least, Siri. Which, let's face it, we could ditch Siri, right?
I'm sorry. I'm afraid I can't do that.
I find this setting to be much better than the default settings because all the buttons I need are right in front of me and the Touch Bar stays awake as long as you're actively using the computer. If the screen does go to sleep, you can simply touch the trackpad to wake it back up or just start typing again. So now that I got my expanded control strip enabled, you can go a step further and customize the Touch Bar with buttons that you might want to use often. To customize the Touch Bar, go to System Preferences, select Keyboard, then near the bottom, click Customizable Control Strip. A list of buttons and their functions will pop up on your screen. You simply grab whichever buttons you want to add to your Touch Bar and drag them down off the screen and onto the Touch Bar. You'll see a new icon appear on your Touch Bar and you can move it right to left to drop it in your desired location. So for example, I take a lot of screenshots for work. So I'm going to grab the screenshot icon and drag it down to my Touch Bar and put it in a place that's easy for me to reach. And boom, there's now a hotkey to take a quick screenshot whenever I need it. Okay, so let's talk about the customizable buttons. We have the sleep button to quickly put your computer to sleep. There's a screensaver button to turn on and off your screensaver. There's a do not disturb button, which could come in handy. A night shift button and a dictation button so you can easily start a dictation session on your computer.
Hey, subscribe to How to Do It All.
If you want to customize the Touch Bar a bit more, you can use the FN key, which can shift between function keys and app buttons. Go to System Preferences, select Keyboard, then find FN key 2 and select your choice from the drop-down menu. You have two other choices, which are Show Quick Actions and Show Spaces, which will pop up your open workspaces. So there you have it. That's a brief overview of how to customize your MacBook Pro's Touch Bar to make it more useful and less annoying. Please give us a like and ring that bell for more videos from How to Do It All. And if you haven't checked out some of our other Apple-related videos, make sure you check out Chris Parker's video on how to set up your iPhone as a webcam. Super handy. Also, let us know what is your favorite button on the Touch Bar. Is it the screenshot button, the Do Not Disturb button, or Siri? Leave us a comment and thanks for watching.